temperatures today that are going to get into the upper 50s. Good looking weather for the Commanders game. They're playing at 1 o'clock at Northwest Field, taking on the Cowboys, hoping for a victory with that one. And on Monday, we're going to get a victory weather. 62 degrees with sunshine, perfect for traveling. A few rain showers possible Tuesday morning, but it looks like it'll be dry Tuesday afternoon and evening for anyone that's going to be traveling. Wednesday looks good. Rain is likely in a fair amount of it on Thursday for Thanksgiving.
I will keep our eye on that. Thank you, Ryan. Right now, back to Sunday Today with Willie Geist. Have a great...
Kacey Musgraves performing her song The Architect at this week's Country Music Association Awards in Nashville. A couple of weeks ago, The Architect was nominated for Best Country Song and Best Country Solo Performance at the upcoming Grammy Awards. Musgraves also is nominated for Best Country Album. That acclaimed record, Deeper Well, debuted in March at number one on Billboard's album sales chart, followed by a sold-out tour. Over the last decade or so, the 36-year-old Texan has transcended the country label, while earning a reputation as one of the best songwriters in all of music. Kacey and I got together a few months back for a Sunday sit-down and a stroll through New York's Greenwich Village. Kacey Musgraves finds inspiration on a walk in the park.
Really? It's a great mix of wholesome and illegal activities here in Washington Park.
So you pick things up and you see somebody or hear something and maybe sprinkle it into a lyric.
I feel like this park is like so alive. It's just kind of a common ground. Life is congregating together and I don't know, there's something cool about that.
My Saturn has returned.
Musgraves recorded her latest album, Deeper Well, just steps from New York's Washington Square Park at the legendary Electric Lady Studios.
I'm so excited to be in the room where it happened, as they say. This is where Deeper Well was sort of conceived in this room.
Totally, I was very drawn to getting out of Nashville and creating somewhere where there was a different energy, a different kind of life bubbling around you, and I just think New York is one of the most unique cities in the world, so it's inspiring for sure.
The seven-time Grammy's last two albums made her a global star, beginning with 2018's Golden Hour, written as Musgraves was falling in love with fellow singer-songwriter Rustin Kelly. Then, 3 years later, came Star Crossed,
and the darkness
came. Released in the wake of the couple's divorce.
Golden Hour is I Found Love. Mm-hmm. Star Crossed is the Shakespearean, I'm in pain, I have heartbreak.
Yeah.
And that brings us to Deeper Well,
right,
which is what kind of album for you?
It feels very grounded. I'm 35. I feel like I know myself better than maybe in the past. Deeper Well is more maybe like some of the older albums, which is more just like observations on life and just human emotion and nature and like lightness, darkness, like God.
You take the title track, you take Deeper Well, which I think you said something like, this album is me ruthlessly clearing out my life.
Ruthlessly removing resistance to growth. And that could mean a lot of different things. Everything has a season, you know, even friendships, even love, business relationships, whatever. And some are meant to go, I think, the long haul, and then maybe some aren't.
There's some growing up in that song.
Maybe some growing up, but not all the way, just like a little bit.
Musgraves was born and raised in the tiny town of Golden, Texas, where she always was ready with a song.
When did music come into your life?
It's hard to even remember a time where I wasn't there. I think I was always just carrying around, you know, one of those like 80s, 90s karaoke little tape machines with like the spiral cord and the mic. Just always kind of singing, and then my family like noticed that I had a kind of a knack for that.
So you were writing songs when you were like 8, 9 years old?
9, I think, was my first
one.
And it's such a thirsty title. It was called Notice Me. I don't know, like, Notice Me. Yeah, it was a soft launch.
Your career.
Well, she was my original booking agent. She had such a big part in making things happen.
With the whole family behind her, Kacey took her show on the road, singing and yodeling at festivals, fairs, and even the Today Show. At 18, Musgraves auditioned for the TV music competition, Nashville Star.
I'm halfway to Memphis.
She finished seventh, but found a new home.
You realize I need to be in Nashville.
Yeah, I was eventually like, I just need to be here.
Those grindy 4 or 5 years before your first album came out, what were those years like for you?
I went full tilt into songwriting. And I had so much fun doing that that I was like, forgive me, a performer. That is too public facing. And I would only want to do it if it felt totally right and I could really be me. Years passed, I write hundreds of songs. I noticed myself going, okay, I don't want to turn this song in for another artist. I think this one's for me. Long story short, I ended up signing the record deal.
She released her debut single, Merry-Go-Round.
You're telling a small town story, but it's not just Friday night lights and all the good parts. You say, let's be real about it.
Right, again, it's the human experience. It's maybe the thing someone doesn't really want to talk about, but it's something we're all experiencing.
What was the message you were getting from the label?
This is depressing. It's not going to do well for a first time, like female in country. It's going to go down in flames, but I'm just like, okay, well, if I am going to go down in flames, I'd rather it be wholeheartedly for something that I truly believe in.
It does take guts on your first album because that could be the end. If it doesn't work out.
I don't know
out,
why that didn't occur to me. But yeah, and then it, you know, goes on to win like Grammy Song of the Year. And it's like, okay, that internal compass means something.
I'm sure the same people who are telling you, you can't do this the first time, are saying, that was great. Oh, we knew it all along.
Of course. It's, we'll do it again. We did it.
Among the countless moments and 6 Grammys that have followed, one stands out.
Golden Hour, Kacey Musgraves!
Golden Hour just took things to a totally different level, in part because it won Album of the Year, not just the Country Album of the Year. Was that a shocker?
Oh my God, yes.
Like, it looked like it was when they announced your name.
Yeah, my eye like closed. It did a weird, I don't know what happened there. But to have like something that you put your entire heart into, given that by peers and industry people, it's really special. And then, you know, life changes. Like, you know, you're on a high from that, and you're going through a divorce. Somewhat shortly after that, it's life is duality. It's highs, it's lows, it's all the things. Everything has seasons, so I'm thankful to have beautiful little chapters of like little scrapbooks of moments.
And how do you feel in this chapter right now of your life?
I feel really good. I feel like I'm where I need to be. I feel grateful.
Kacey's album, Deeper Well, is available wherever you get your music, and her world tour continues tomorrow night in Austin, Texas. A big thanks again to the iconic Electric Lady Studios in New York for hosting our conversation. Don't forget to subscribe to the Sunday Sit Down podcast to hear the full extended interview with Kacey Musgraves, including much more on her process for writing those beautiful songs. You can find our conversation wherever you get your podcasts. And next week, a favorite Sunday sit-down with the legendary Billy Joel at home on his native Long Island as we walk through 50 years of some of the most famous songs in the history of music. Billy Joel, next week on Sunday Today. Let's turn now and get another quick check of your local Sunday weather.
And good morning. I'm from Team 4 Meteorologist Ryan Miller. Looking at sunshine later on this afternoon and mild conditions as we get up to the upper 50s, near 60 degrees. Great weather if you plan to hit the Commanders game. And if you're traveling, we've got fine weather tomorrow. 62 degrees for your Monday. We'll go ahead and label that milder. Rain is a possibility here on Tuesday morning, but will dry out into the afternoon if you're traveling. Wednesday is going to be fine for travel, but Thursday, Thanksgiving, expect a fair amount of heavy rain.
Today, our highs and lows of the week, including the toddler who refused to step out of its vehicle and then fell asleep at the wheel. You hate to see it. But up next, our Sunday spotlight on the high-tech effort to keep track of thousands of humpback whales off the coast of California with the help of artificial intelligence. Sunday Today is coming right back.
correct time.